This is an exciting video because we're going to broaden our horizons and talk about values other than numbers. So numbers are values in DrRacket, and so are what's called strings. A string represents a piece of text. It can be English, it can be Finnish, it can be Chinese. I'm going to type in English. Words in English consist of characters, things like dog, cat, frog. But English text can also contain spaces in it. Here's a space. In order to tell Racket, then, where a string begins and where it ends, we need a special symbol. That special symbol is not going to surprise you too much. It's the same one that we use when we are describing a piece of text in a book. It's the double quote. Double quote indicates the beginning of a string. You'll see that my text is all red here, and the reason for that is because Racket is concerned that I have no matching close quote. So there it is. It's closing. It now indicates that this thing is a single string, and you will notice that it is no longer blue. Here's another one. Dog, cat, frog, donkey. This one was blue. This one is green. Okay. Green indicates these simple values, values such as strings. If I were to put donkey in quotes, then it would also have turned green. Okay. There are also some operators we can use on strings. For instance, the string append operator. The string append operator. Can we guess? Do you have a guess? Pause. Take a guess. Good job. It takes two strings and combines them into one. Note that in particular, it does not insert any spaces or other characters. So if there's no space at the end of the first string and no space at the beginning of the second one, then they're going to go right together and we're going to get a donkey dog. Whatever the heck that is. Okay. Naturally, as we've seen before, we can apply operators to the result of applying operators. We can say string length, for instance. What is the length of this string? Well, it's the length of the first string plus the length of the second string. And I have no idea what that's going to be. It's 18. Okay. So that's what I have to tell you about strings. They're formed with a quote at the beginning and a quote at the end. Applying operators to strings, which is very much like applying operators to numbers. It involves a pair of parens, the name of an operator, and the name of the arguments. And nesting of expressions, which is, again, exactly the same as it was with numbers.